Eugen, welcome. Eugen Jebeleanu, the director of Poppy Field, one of the 9 features that we present in the Making Waves online showcase. We have to say that Poppy Field was also included in our in-person event that took place in December at Jacob Burns Film Center. You are supposed to be there, you are not. Maybe that's why we decided to have you here and talk about the film for the audience. First, what I want to point out from the very beginning is that this film is a first for many people involved in the film. On one side, you have a super experienced producer, Velvet Moraru, who produced the autobiography of Nicolae Ceaușescu. The film has a super experienced director of photography, Marius Panduru, but the director, which is you, Eugen Jebeleanu, you're at your first film. And besides, you never made films, you were not supposed to make films, but somehow you ended up making cinema, so this is your first feature. The script of this very complex and intriguing film is written by a first-time scriptwriter, Ioana Moraru. And last but not least, the main part of the film, the protagonist, the main actor of the film is at his first prominent role in cinema, Konrad Merikofer. He did play some parts in other Romanian films before. He's also flirting with this idea of directing films. He made some short films. So this is like a contrast between some experienced people who did believe that you are able to put everything together in order to make a strong film. If you want to comment a bit this like context, I mean, because it was to me, it looks like you are having like a very heavy and big responsibility to deliver.
Yes, I was not expecting to have this crew with Marius Panduru and with all the others, Cătălin Cristuțiu and all the other people in the crew later in the production, and I was really glad that Velvet, the producer, was very, protective somehow with me. And I think it was good that I was not making cinema before in that way, because I was not impressed somehow, and so I felt like I just discover a new field and something that doesn't make me feel, I don't know, in pressure with what I know or what I don't know, or all these people that are doing and they have a lot of experience. And I had a very good dialogue with Ioana, and I think that was really important at the beginning, because we worked like for 2 or 3 years, I don't remember exactly, on the script and on the development of this film. And I took also people from my work, like Velica Panduru and also Konrad, with who I already worked in theater a few times. And so it was a meeting between what I have to give and what they have to give to me for making
something. And what you knew and what you didn't know.
Exactly. And I haven't felt in pressure, and that was amazing. I was like very cool with all what happened, and even if I was afraid at the beginning, because I didn't knew how it will be, but I felt responsible, as you say, first of all to tell this story, and I felt the good that I am the good person to tell it today, here, now, in very close with my own opinions and with my fight and with my own artistic, way, even if it's in theater.
Yeah, let's talk about this, because, well, that was the first part of the question. The second one, obviously, it will deal with the content of the film. I know that Velvet, the producer of the film, specifically wanted you to direct the film, knowing that you have no prior experience in cinema. And the story is triggered, let's say, by a real incident, which I want you to talk a little bit about it. Why did you feel like the right person to tell the story?
Yes. So the story, very shortly, it's based on the incident that happened in a cinema hall in Bucharest, when a group of Orthodox people interrupted the screening, and they made a big scandal there. And so it was the screening of an LGBT film in 2013, the first time, and lately even in 2018. And
it was The Kids Are All Right.
The Kids Are All Right. That was the first
film,
one,
because it's relevant for the US audience.
Yes, that was the film that was interrupted back then.
Yeah.
And then Ioana wrote this fictional story with this policeman that goes to the cinema where it's interrupted the screening of this LGBT film, and his struggle between his personal secret life as a gay person and his professional life as a gendarme, and all this secret that he has. And it's this portrait in 24 hours somehow of what happens inside in the conflict that he lives with. And why I am the right person, I was not thinking about it, just came like this, because I'm doing a lot of things, even in theater, based on this topic, because I am a gay person, because I feel that I have to tell something about things that are struggling myself in my life. It's not the only topic that I'm interested in, but it's something that makes me be being connected to my life and what I deal with in my everyday life.
It was more relatable.
Exactly.
So to say.
That's why, not because I have something more than others to say, but just because I feel honest to talk about
and
this.
More connected to, yeah, to this. So, do you think? I mean, just to divert a bit, do you think that, let's say, a straight director, either a woman or a male director, would have brought a different, maybe not so true to the story to it? I mean, what did you bring, let's say, more and more true to the topic than other directors? You know, this is somehow in the line of this recent discussion, you know, which is applies mostly to actors, that a certain type of character should play by an actor who share in real life that specific trait of the character. So in this respect, telling a story about a guy, a closeted guy, a gay guy, like Poppyfield, is told by a director who's equally gay, okay, not closeted, because you are like an open, you live your life as a gay person in the open. It's, let's say, the right thing to do. Does this apply, maybe, from your opinion? I mean,
yes.
Telling a story about a gay character played by an actor who's, let's say, not gay. Yeah. How do you comment on this?
Yes. No, I think
in
that
real life.
Yeah.
I mean,
yes.
Yeah.
Of course. I think that let's say straight people should do also films about LGBT topics, and I think that even I will do things that are not related to this topic. So I hope we are not just that
pigeonholing.
No, I hope so. And for example, as you are saying, in my film, Konrad, that is playing this gay character, he's not a gay person in his real life, and I don't think that the representation should be like this. So I think stories about these minority people has to be more and more and seen on cinema or stage, and to have more visibility. But that doesn't mean that just people that are with that sexual orientation should play gay characters, for example, because it's not your identity of I have heard a few days ago an interview with Kate Blanchett, and she said something very interesting, like, if I am a lawyer, that I'm playing a lawyer, nobody will ask me how many hours I spend in the work of a lawyer. But if I'm a lesbian character, everybody is asking me how I felt to play this lesbian character. So no, it's a profession to be an actor, and I think that's the beauty of this, what we are doing, cinema or theater, that we are trying to tell stories that are not ours, but somehow with our skills and to be connected with ourselves. What was important for me and with in the work with Konrad, for example, it's we have never talked about how this guy is having his intimate sexual life, because I think it's not the point of the character and not the story.
Even though you show it on screen.
And yeah, but
for an actor, it's a, there could be a challenge.
Of course.
Yeah.
But I mean, I don't know. I will tell something maybe anecdotal, like, sorry, I don't know how to say. I had an actor who came to the audition and he asked me if the guy is top or bottom. So, and I think it's not the question of how we
Well, you know, there are actors who like to know everything in detail.
Yeah,
because they,
I know, but
yeah,
I think it's interesting of how you think about gay characters. And anyway, but we have worked with Konrad on what himself, with his life, with his opinions, has to tell in that character. So something to bring from his inner conflict, mm-hmm. even if it's in another part. Mm-hmm. But all my work, it's in the work with the actors, I mean, it's not how we deal to take the actor to the character, but how we took the character to the actor. So mm-hmm. it's that way. And yeah.
And talking about the story, when you first got the script, what did seduce you the most? I mean, what did you like the most about it? Because I read the reviews on this film and how it was interpreted by various outlets and by various contacts abroad. What did you like the most? The accusation part of it, the way the society is described, and the intolerance. I mean, mm-hmm. this like very manifesto part of it, or the inner struggle of a character that you could relate yourself, which also you took, as far as I'm concerned, a huge risk in dealing with a let's say problematic gay character, mm-hmm. which is not necessarily in the vein of glorification mm-hmm. or I don't know. I mean, it's more complex. Some people could say that it's kind of difficult to empathize with Konrad's character in this film, because everything he does, it's not relatable. I mean, he's mean with his lover, he's mean with his sister, he's committing a microaggression in the cinema. So all his acts are doesn't lead the audience to feel sympathetic mm-hmm. towards him. So what did you?
Yeah.
What was your like main interest in mm-hmm. When you read the script? What mm-hmm. What was appealing for you?
First of all, the background of this story and that it's inspired by this real event, it was important because it put all the story into social, political, somehow situation that makes my work necessary. Why I'm doing this film? Because of that. And after, because I want to answer to what happened there, because I want to say that we should continue and we should abuse somehow of our freedom of expression and not doesn't let people like this interrupting screenings of LGBT films. So that's the first thing, this manifesto. And after the character of Christy, it was, I think the main part of my interest, because as you are saying, what I searched in this character, it's not to make a hero character, because I think he's in the same time a victim, but also
the bully.
The bully, yeah. And so it's how we deal to show into this character also that at his place he is also aggressing someone. And so that's again something that I'm working and searching in all my work, how we can tell stories of characters that are not positive or negative or something like this, because I don't believe in all that stuff, and I'm more interested in how and from where and why the violence come to someone. And I think that's why The acting of Konrad is also very important, because he did, with all his silence and all his way of listening what is happening in the film, something that gives to this character something more mysterious and more also maybe not sympathetic, as you say, but something more real somehow, if that's the good word. I don't word I don't know, but anyway, it's the way of telling the story of an LGBT person without making from this, as you say, a glorification of
or a manifesto,
that,
or a manifesto. Let's say propaganda, maybe it's a bit strong of a word.
I was not interested in that.
So, for the people who are going to watch this film, what would you like them to get from your film? I mean, what do you want them to understand? Mm-hmm. What would you please you to find out that the audience understood? From your film, especially in the way you close the film. Mm-hmm. I don't want necessarily to, mm-hmm. it's not like revealing, because we are talking for people who supposedly watch the mm-hmm. film and want to know a bit more, so it's not like a plot spoiler what happens at the end of the film, but what would you like the audience to be left with after mm-hmm. watching the film?
Unfortunately, the life of one person doesn't change in 24 hours completely, and that's because also the society, it's like it is, and even if he understood something with himself, he cannot wake up next day and life
is
different person and everything is going good. Well, so
but he do have some revelation
of course,
at the end of the
of
film,
course, of course.
Which are supposedly helping him to understand more about himself.
Yeah, yes, of course. I don't know what I want the film to be the beginning of a conversation after. Mm-hmm. So if my film it's making this prologue of life, what comes after you go out from the cinema, I think it's enough. It's already
mission
something.
Accomplished.
Exactly, because it's something that the film made into one person mentality, or between two person, a discussion, a family, a child with his parent. I don't know, but something that just bring a discussion on. And secondly, I would like to think, I'm not sure that I did that, but I would like to think also that the film, it's not just about this conflict with the sexual orientation. And I would like to think also that I made a film that it's telling the story of someone with his emotional problems, and with this difficulty of knowing himself and of dealing with who he is. Mm-hmm. And I hope in my future projects and or even in theater or film, I would arrive to tell stories like this, maybe with LGBT characters, but without making of all that the topic of the film. Mm-hmm. And I think that would be, and I would like to, make this next step.
Mm. Mission even more accomplished.
Exactly.
So, and last but not least, I mean, for those of in the virtual audience who are gonna ask themselves why this like very metaphorical, let's say, title, Poppy Field, if you can give them a hint.
Yes, it's very easy. It came during the shooting, and it was that moment when Christy, the main character, is in the middle of this cinema hall, and when Marius Panduru, the director of the photography, did this image, I said to him, wow, it looks like a poppy field. And that's...
So that was not the original title?
No,
it's
no,
the title
no.
You came up with during the shooting.
Exactly. And it was something metaphorical, but it stayed in my mind. And I don't know, I maybe it's because of that, because I didn't want it to have a title that is saying, I don't know, the gay gendarme or something. So something to have maybe more to let the people, the audience, to be free with their imagination, as
and
I was.
And interpretation.
Yeah, and interpretation. And also, I think there are links that are between my projects, because, for example, in my theater project Itineraries that I did in the same time with this film, I finished the performance with the actors that are putting some puppies on stage, and I don't know, maybe there was links that are into.
Like always in a in an artist's career, everything communicates from one piece of work to another. Thanks so much, Eugen.
Thanks too.
Good luck with your next projects in theater and
cinema.
In cinema. And see you soon.
See you, and thank you very much.